Hello everybody and welcome to this webinar on the Dynamicweb PIM and the product information. May I say, still say good morning. It's just a few minutes past the hour, just giving the last participants an opportunity to get into the meeting room and get everything with from the start. This presentation is held in English, and due to the rather large number of participants again today, which we are very lucky to have, I must say that I have decided to shut down for the opportunity to ask questions directly in this webinar. But please feel free afterwards to send me an email or give me a call, and I'll be happy to answer any questions that you might have. My name is Tony Grein. I'm the sales manager here at Dynamicweb Software. I'm placed in Aarhus, Denmark, and I am also the country manager for the Danish market. So I've been visiting, of course, customers and looking into what their needs and benefits are and regarding the Dynamicweb product information management, the PIM software, so to speak. My phone number and my email address here. The presentation that you'll about to see will be sent out to you afterwards in a PDF. So I'll send all the information to you. And again, if you need a demo version to tap into or work with, please give me a heads up and I'll create one for you so that you can look into the platform, of course. I have prepared a short agenda for this 40-minute meeting. We have the introduction to Dynamicweb, to the company, and of course to the platform. And we'll look at the all-in-one platform capabilities from our point of view, what we're looking into and what we are offering our customers. Of course, deep dive into the Dynamicweb PIM as we can do it here online. And I'll do a live demo of the PIM before we end this today's webinar. Everything is live on set. Except, of course, here the presentation, so we can work with whatever comes in. Introduction to Dynamicweb. As we said, the Dynamicweb is the only platform combining CMS, PIM, e-commerce, and digital marketing, and those headlines I'll just tap into here. The company Dynamicweb has been profitable since 1999, and we are now represented in more than 13 countries. Our latest newcomers, so to speak, is Holland and Norway, where we have our own office today. And with more than 200 certified partners around the world, we are happy to say our platform is well known and well used across Europe and across the world. We have more than 4,000 customers. I think the number is now more. Up to 5,000 customers, but in that number, still with 12,000 websites. And today we are expecting more than 3 million visitors again, like yesterday, on our platform. So in terms of scalability, I think we can match whatever number you might see today or be expecting today on your own sites. Why choose Dynamicweb? As I said earlier, we have a lot of products combined in one platform. And yesterday, I was actually having a meeting with a potential customer again, alongside a partner, where we tapped into each one of those balls. And every time they had a question, I said, okay, we can do that also, because we have, of course, the B2B e-commerce platform. We have, of course, the B2C e-commerce platform. Then they were asking me about a business-to-agent platform. Could we do an agent platform in the solution also? And I said, yes, because that's also something that we have done for our customers, or something our partner has done for one of our customers based on the platform. We are, of course, mobile ready. We are, of course, also channel ready. That's one of the balls that's not actually presented here, but we have also have channel strategy. I'll show you that in the PIM presentation. You can, of course, create the self-service portal with Dynamicweb. You can create email marketing. You can do campaigns. You can do leads. And, of course, something as basic as doing a website, of course, also on our platform. As I said, more than 4,000 great customers, and this slide is not even enough for showing some of the biggest platform. And even that's not even the purpose of this slide. The purpose here is actually to give you a small idea of different solutions one of our partners or some of our partners have done with different kinds of customers. So when we tap into each one of those company here, they have got a small special thing in the Dynamicweb platform already, so that they have been able to create their own platform based on the Dynamicweb Microsoft.net platform. Of course, today we are looking into the PIM as the new coming into, but the platform is content, e-commerce marketing, and PIM, the all-in-one platform that I'm going to present you. We have our data source on the left side, being ERP, CRM, PIM. Then we have, of course, also our suppliers, and then we have the channel on the right side, being websites, as I said, online stores, email marketing, and so forth, that you can use and reuse all the data that you get in the all-in-one platform from Dynamicweb into. The key advantages is one is, of course, a single platform for your digital world. And what we see today is actually a picture like this. Even yesterday with my customer, with the potential customer I was talking to, they had a CMS. They have, of course, an e-commerce marketing platform, ERP, PIM, and CRM lying next to the platform, so to speak. And all data was then transferred into Excel spreadsheets where they were maintained, updated, and worked with, and then passed on into the next system via an import, manually, of course. And they were very proud of this, how their system worked. And they said, we have all the spreadsheets running and everything it goes. And of course, mistakes happen, but I could also do an online platform. And that's what they were happy to use. My question was, of course, very, very shortly was, who's got the truth here? Who's got actually the truth on your platform? Because who's got the latest updated Excel sheet before they are tapped into the system? And actually, in this GDPR times, the question is relevant, because where is customer data running? Where's buying? Where's the latest invoices sent out? Where are they all running in the system? Could some of them be printed and laid in a company car, a sales rep's portfolio, or whatever? So what we are offering is the complete platform, as you can see it here. We have all the data kept together in one platform. We have the integrations running to the ERP systems, to other systems, Advanticom or whatever you might have into. We have the content running, we have the e-commerce, we have the marketing, we have the PIM rolling into one and the same platform here in Dynamicweb. And from there, you can take small pieces of data, you can take the whole product range, you can take a market out and work with directly in the platform still, but be able to expand the data use by using this platform. The key customer advantages, as I see it personally, is you, of course, as I said, you get the all-in-one platform. You don't have to run multiple systems except for the ERP system, of course. Then Dynamicweb could actually be the multi-tool for you to use. You have all your data in one place, one database with all customer interactions, and you can work with and utilize the data coming in there. Once you are trained in Dynamicweb, and that comes actually in the implementation already, but once you get to work with Dynamicweb, it's very intuitive, I find it, and therefore also a single skill set is required, because when you can work in one part of the platform, as I'm about to show you, you can use it different places in the platform. Reuse data, automize, personalize, segment your data, of course, you got fewer interactions. That's the last two balls of the key customer advantages. Looking specifically into the PIM and the PIM setup as companies have it today, we have the ERP system, of course, the mother of all data, where we have all the products lying. Normally, we see it today. Then we got the e-commerce, where we send data to and we sell our products from. Then we got the PIM going in back and forth between the PIM, of course, and the e-commerce, sending data back and forth. And that also goes up to the ERP system. That is the setup we know it as we know it today. It works. It's not perfect, and it's not perfect in many ways, but one of the things that I have experienced personally comes in as a major obstacle in this model is what happens if I update one of those three. Let's say the ERP get an update. We have Microsoft Dynamics NAV Business Central coming in. What if it's on-premise solution that you are having because you have done some extensions to the platform already, to the Business Central? Then you would actually need to update both the PIM and the e-commerce also afterwards. And while you're doing that, data is missing, data is falling out, and data is not maintained correctly. What Dynamicweb is offering is this platform. We are saying here we have the ERP on the one side, and we have an integration framework running to the e-commerce and the PIM, and all product data is coming over there, and therefore maintained in the PIM and e-commerce, going back to the ERP, and of course going out to all the channels that you would like to have it work with. Those are small screenshots of the platform as we know it, as we see it today. And actually, I'm going to show you all this going into the live. So I'll be not using a lot of hours here, but of course we'll get into that the minute we get into the platform, because here you have the product monitoring where you can use smart sets, you can define dashboard widgets, and you can send automatic email notifications, you get workflows. But I'll show you that in the live demo. The product overview is also something I'm tapping into, and I'll take in the where data could come from and where data could be maintained in the platform, just to give an idea of what we are capable of. And afterwards, you'll be able to work with the data. Again, if you would like a demo solution of our software to work with yourself, I'll be happy to provide it to you. I got this multiple product overview here. That says some of the advantages of the platform. That's why one of our major advantages in total is to go into a new market and expand the use of Dynamicweb and of course your products. Because the minute you decide to open up a new market, let's say Sweden, for instance, then you have the master data in the PIM already, and then you can just tap on the flag and open up a new country, getting it translated, and then coming back to the platform and then be able to be sent out on the channel that you are using, whether it's Amazon, it could be Google Shopping, or it could be your own website, of course, based on the Dynamicweb, I suppose. In the Dynamicweb PIM also comes a live product view in e-commerce, as you know here, but also comes in a standard PIM frontend. So whatever data we have in the PIM, or you get this small digital asset management tool, not to be a total DAM, but still you get this front end that you can use out of the box for customers or supplier portals. We have created this return on invest sheet for our customers, just to show into what the benefit of using Dynamicweb and how fast the kickback comes. But this sheet, of course, you can download at our website to work with your own numbers to see whether or not it actually gives advantage for you to take the Dynamicweb platform in. Going into a short step into the integration, actually it's just this one slide, because technically I don't think webinars are the best way to do it, but here we have actually the framework for a rapid deployment, as I'm calling it, because once you get the standard Dynamicweb in, we have of course also turnkey solutions to tap into, and we are integrating with the NAV X 365, the new Business Central or Business Operations coming in, or any other back office system that you might use today. I think that we can say honestly that 95% of all the ERP systems in the world we know of and we can integrate into. So now I'm going into a demo of the Dynamicweb solution, of course also the Dynamicweb PIM, and it will be a live demo, so bear with me if there will be some delays in the voice or the screens. I'll try to be as slow speaking so that everybody can get the right product into. This is the logon screen at the Dynamicweb software where I log into. As you can see, I have already put my credentials into it. And before I log in, I would like to change the language of the platform. As I mentioned in the beginning, I'm placed here in Denmark, so for me it's nice to work with the Danish language. But actually we have different languages in the platform already, so that you just can tap into whatever you would like to work with. And if your local language is not there, please give me a heads up, and then we can maybe do a translation of it to your market. That would not be very difficult. But in order to keep this in plain, I'll do an English platform. So I'm just signing in, and all the commands over here, the content, the files, the e-commerce, the PIM, the marketing, and if I go into, for instance, at a content, you will see all information here is in English now. But this is the dashboard when you log into Dynamicweb, where you can see the pages in total, you can see the visits in total, you have the users, and you have the email subscribers. And as you can see, those tiles here, you would like to export, for instance, to SharePoint or to any other information channel where you're looking into your platform. You get it in here, and then you can export it from here. You can also edit the workplace in order to get your own personal view of what you might want to see in this welcome tile. I've just sent this up as a demo standard, and to be quite honest, every night this goes back to standard for me personally, but for you, you can have it as whatever you would like to. Diving into the content. Again here, I must say we have a master site, and then I have different languages put in already. When we open into the content, you can see we have the master here up here in standard showing up, but I can see that I have also have a Danish, a Deutsch, and a French portal in here, a French shop, so to speak. And I've got my PIM tool here. The reason why the PIM tool comes with an English flag here is because I have decided by integrating this PIM in my solution, again, it's for me as a customer, so to speak. I said all my master data is in English and is maintained in English. And that's why, because that's just because of if I wanted to do a translation of our product information, for instance, into Dutch, then it would be very easy for a Dutch interpreter to do translations from the English platform instead of from the Danish platform, because they would do a third translation before they go on. So that's why I have a PIM in Master English, and I have my shop here in Master English. When I click on the front page, this gray field that you have here in the screen shows up with different categories. And this is actually what my front page contains. I have a banner, I have a category, I have a contest to win a bike, of course. And I got some promotion road bikes that are not included at the moment because they are not active. And I have a quick ordering menu to come into. If I click on the show page, which I'm not going to do here, but if I do, I can see, however, I can see the page, and I can work with the layout as I see it here. I could also do a front end editing. When I click on this button, it will take some time, but then the page actually shows up as if I were going into to the shop or online. Take some seconds, I know, but once it comes up here, I can actually work with the front page directly in here instead of working in the backend. I'm just shutting it down because it takes too long and we have to respect the time that we have set up to this meeting. But you know the drill. If I go in and click on the product side to show what the product side will come up, I will have this product overview on how it's set up, and I can of course again show page, and I can do a front end editing. As you can see right now, I'm working on the English side, on the master side. But if I were to work directly on the Danish side or the German side, I could actually choose that from here. But let me just work on the master here. Clicking on the products, just to click, go a deep dive in to see how the product site is set up. I have some text fields, I have some products set up, and I have different kinds of showing on the screen setup, and how it should look on small devices, how my content is positioned, and of course, how my image should be styled. I've got different kinds of tools into how I can set up this product site. All this, as you can see here at the very bottom, not hidden, but now it should be very clear, is based on Rapido. And later today, I have a webinar on Rapido that I'll go into what setup you can make here. But this is actually how we work with the different sites in the solution. I'll go into the about. I also, you can see, I have some different kinds of tabs into here also. This is the about site as you see it in our shop. And we have, of course, a small video. We have some product informations, and I got, of course, also a mailing list sign up, and I've got contact information, social media, and whatever you would like to have on your paper page also. And product coming in over here, but I'll get back to that. In the Dynamicweb, you have a complete file system also, as you know it, and we can also integrate into different other file systems that you might use. For instance, an image bank at your supplier or whatever. I've put the assortments in here, so I have my branch logo and the different branch logo in here already. And I've got pictures also for the e-commerce where products are lined in here. As you can see it, those are logged into the Dynamicweb directly. going back to the images, since you would see there's some pictures here that I would like to actually to move. And it's actually as easy as this. You click on the picture and delete them from the file, and it says yes. Everywhere the picture would now be used would be replaced now, and I'll be adding some pictures again afterwards. The major advances here on the user side again, and is actually also is used in the PIM. If I just take a customer side, that's something new. In these GDPR times, and yes, we are also struck by it here in Denmark, of course, all the consents given are actually stamped down on the customer card, as you can see it here. Now, this demo user, myself as a demo user, has not given any consent at any cases, but here I actually could use it. And all my consents handle out in the PIM or in the e-commerce on the content page will actually be stamped into here, where I can maintain that I can delete them and I can show the customer what consents are given and where they are coming from. If I were to actually upload pictures of it of your customer, I could also do that here. And you can see actually we have a tab from the previous picture that we have into this solution. Actually, the picture I just deleted a short second ago. The e-commerce here is again with a tile board. I'm not going to spend a lot of minutes in here, but actually e-commerce is also fully integrated in our platform, of course, alongside the product that we have to talk about, mainly the PIM. All information here is either placed in the e-commerce or in the ERP system, and when then handled in this PIM tool here. Just to take a step to the side for just a second, normally you would have different kinds of users in the ERP system maintaining different kinds of data. You would have a German product manager, you would have a product manager responsible for bikes or clothing, or a customer manager, for instance. They would require each a license in, for instance, Microsoft Dynamics NAV or Business Central to be able to work with the product. At Dynamicweb, we turn this around because you buy one license, so to speak, and then you can put all the users that you might need into the platform. So you have one license, and then you can put 300 users in, for instance. In here, you then do a segmentations or role-based setup on what each user can come into, so that if my good friend Alex was in the system and he was responsible for the Dutch market, then Alex would actually be limited to only see and work with the products published on the Dutch market or the Dutch side, so to speak, and be not granted access to the other sides of this company in here, this bike shop. On the other hand, we can also do a role as I'm having it here, and that's the first time I've ever been called an angel, but here I am actually in as an angel. So all the data that is in the platform I can work with, and I can work with directly. I can go across channels here. So the role-based system that we know it and that we're coming to know more of it from Microsoft is actually adapted into this product. So again here, when we are talking about products here today, please bear with me. I mean, as an angel, I'm not here as a certain kind of role, but the role-based system is working and is a very useful tool here in Dynamicweb. And I'll be happy to do a presentation for you if necessary. Having said that, back on the track. This dashboard here actually shows me both products ready for translations, product where you have a red box where 35 products is missing with where content validation is missing on product. You have 27 products ready for marketing, and you have 10 new products, just to take out four of the six. Those boxes are actually connected to a workflow. So when 10 new products has arrived, as you can see in my warehouse and sorry, of course, in my shared queries and in my workflow, you can see I have workflow 0 called newly arrived products. That's a 10 here. And I've got a number 1 with ready for technical data bikes. And I've got a workflow 3 ready for the product manager here on the clothing. And then I have the number 5 here ready for marketing. And I can have different kinds of solutions running into. The workflows in here can be generated and put up as you would like to have them, and they can trigger an email, a text message, or whatever information that you would like to send to the next in line for the workflow in here. Going into the newly arrived products, the 10 products we got here, I just click on the newly arrived products in my workflow. Now I want to work with this product, so I don't need all this over here to run into, so I just minimize it for just a second. It will still be there, and they will remember where I came from. This is the 10 new products coming in. I have a supplier that's very nice to me, very kind supplier, maybe a very, very good supplier, because they actually put in the pictures already. That's very nice of them. If the supplier does not have an integration with your PIM, you can actually just import from Excel, as you have the spreadsheet up here. And when I click on it, I can select the file, or I can open up a folder where the file is lying. And I can even search on my local machine to find the folder there. So doing integration with your suppliers has never been easier using Dynamicweb PIM. 10 products coming in. As you can see, my supplier has also been very kind to me, because he has said on two of those products here you have on the screen, there are actually some variants that you have bought, therefore different sizes or different colors, for instance. Let's take a look at the first one. That's a cyclocross from Scatante, maybe Italian. You can actually see here that's the frame size coming in different variants. The picture, of course, is the same, so therefore no new picture attached, because it's actually the same picture as we already have it, very small here on the screen, yes. But the frame sizes are different, therefore the product has been created four times, but all information comes from the product on top. The other products on variant, again, I think here that's also a size issue. Yes, it is. It's the shoes coming in with different kinds of sizes into. And because I know the question is coming in just a second, I actually going down to my clothing in just a second, because one question that I also have is, could variants come in with both different sizes and different colors? And of course, yes, it can be that also. But going back to my newly arrived product, the feature in Dynamicweb is actually that when I go back and forth to where I was coming from, the Dynamicweb solution actually remembers where I came from, although I haven't saved anything. So those new products are ready, and now I can work with them singularly. If you just click on one product, you have the information coming in, and then you can add a new field, you can add related products, or you can add to group or add property, whatever you would like to have into. Let's say this one here, I actually would like to add something to. You can see the property that I could put into whatever I would like to tab into, and then just press OK on it, and it would come into. I can also do some changing on the visible fields, sorry. And let's say I have material missing, just add that one too. And then I say OK to that. And it updates here. And then I can say nylon here, just for instance. As you can see, this will actually inherit into different kinds of languages. So I have the Danish side here, and I've got a Dutch side over here, where the product is not inherited into yet. But of course, it could come in the minute I save this product. Then the inheritance would come over. Working with different products here. The price in here is actually from the supplier, but that could actually be overwritten by the e-commerce system saying, yes, but this product comes from the supplier for $15.99, as you can see it. But local markets are different, so therefore the prices are changing. Saving and closing this one. Working with all the products, and we also can see all my active products are just giving a spreadsheet of what is running in the platform already. And we have a different kind of product there. Going into inheritance and how to inherit data. As you can see, I have different kinds of warehouses running into here. I have my PIM and bike, my bikes and equipment shop here. That's of course the shop I'm selling from today, though they have got their own warehouse, so to speak. PIM warehouse number two could be for a supplier, And PIM warehouse number 3 could also be a supplier with different areas. So that, for instance, if we were to split Germany up to 3 sections, for instance, we say northern Germany have these products in, mid Germany have these products in, and then south Germany has these products to show in the PIM or in the digital asset management tool, that could be set up as a warehouse itself. I've got my channels in here, and to your big disappointment, you can see it doesn't scroll down because I actually haven't set up any channels in here at the moment. But if I were to set up, for instance, Google or Amazon or Facebook Markets or whatever, it would show in here also alongside with the feeds. But our PIM warehouse, I have taken the data from the ERP system, so to speak, or the tool from the PIM system, so to speak, in this. So I have got my bikes, I've got my components, I got my clothing, I got my accessories, as you would know it in a business central, for instance. But there it actually also stops, because then I'm going at a level down where I'm saying, okay, I have my bikes, and now I have the different bike brands coming into here individually before I have the bike item. And the reason why is, of course, the grouping of this. So I have this product group, so to speak, of the brand names. And when I click on Goose and see the data from this group, actually I've got different kinds of fields where I can put in more data and working with it. I got the brand details and I get pictures of it. And those information is actually inherited down to the products coming into the bikes and into the Mongoose. Or if Mongoose were doing clothing, they would also inherit down there also. We got the manufacturer, we got the VAT group, we got stock status in here. You can put meter information on it. So whatever fields you would like to have, you can put in, or you can remove in order to make it visible for you to work with your data. Clicking on Mongoose, you can see here we have the only bikes in here, so no clothing. I have mountain bikes, road bikes, and hybrid bikes, because again, I can inherit data from product to product. Now I'm just lazy going into the first and looking at the mountain bikes. We have this product here with different kinds of variants on it. But I'm taking the first product in here again. Working with the whole screen, just minimizing the field over here. And then I got all the information that we have on this product. Now, if I were just to focus on the Dutch market, for instance, I could actually remove the Danish flag from here, and now I have a split screen where I have the UK or the master, as I said earlier, and I have the Dutch screen to work with, and then I can work with the data in here. As you can see, for me, the Dutch market and Holland is a new market in this shop. So nothing has been translated yet. No pictures have been assigned. And what to do? Normally you would say, okay, but then we could do a translation here, or we could do a field exploration or whatever. It comes actually very easy here in here, because we have the export to Excel bottom on top, and I can take all the information that I would like into the export. Clicking on export, and now fingers crossed. Oh yeah, came up right there. Just need a second to open Excel. There it was. Now I've got Excel, and I've got the English language in on my left side. On the right side, I've got the Dutch language. Now every field that I would like to work with in this Excel spreadsheet, I can work with. But you can see, for instance, here Mongoose, that field is actually locked, because it comes from a default information from the PIM. But the brand text, of course, could be translated, and I could put data into here also. The reviews could be in the website and color and whatever. But all the other fields are locked. The minute this one is done, actually we can do the import back to the Dynamicweb PIM, and all those fields would be updated. If I just go out on the Dutch market and just open the Germans, for instance, because yeah, here it's actually been translated, and the same product has been product pictures has been added to here. But let's say on the German market, I would also like a different picture that has not been shown in it. I can just click on the upload button, and here all my product comes in. And I could just put my dog in here, and the upload is actually complete, and the product is added. Takes it just a second to open up here, but I'll just skip it again. But actually here I could just upload pictures. And I said, information inherited from the band is coming down here also. And due to the inheritance, I cannot edit in this field here. As you can see, I can tap all that I want, but I cannot edit it because it will all come over from the from the standard side. Now I would just like to jump into the digital asset management system for just a second to show you a last picture on how it all looks when it comes out. Remember, this front page, this explorer, is actually something that is in standard on Dynamicweb. Again, fingers crossed, it's taking some time to open. I could start to sing, but then you will all have to shut up your head speakers, because your loudspeakers, because I'm not singing very good. There it was. Sorry for the delay. Again, everything is live. I have my digital asset in here because in the PIM, as you know from my file structure, I could have pictures, I could have presentations, I could have whatever in here. Actually, here it's our Danish headquarters, our lounge, of course, our reception. In the old picture, I can see maybe we should update that. We have the vice president for sales, we have our CEO, and you have different colleagues in here. I could also say now we just want to look at the documents. And then you can see I have these documents in here. And now I would like to do the integration with e-commerce and PIM. I'd like to have that on a download. Just clicking on it and then say download for original use. Now I'm waiting for Dynamicweb. It comes in here as a folder. And you have the product in here. If I were to use it, for instance, it's a document. So let's take a picture instead. Sorry. No. I'm in picture. Let's take this one. What we have down here is actually a segment tool on how to download the picture here that I'm going to work with. Because if I want it as an original, of course I can download for original, but if it's only, sorry, so to speak, but for print use or for my office products, for instance, Word or Excel, then I can download it in different kinds of formats so that it makes it easier for you to work with. And I can download also in a web format so that I can use it online. The minute I click download, the picture comes up here. And you get a JPEG and you get the picture in here. Easy to use. This I can also do with my products, of course. Clicking on the product and then clicking on the mountain bikes. And again, we just need to update the site. And here it was. So on the Mongoose Tarix Comp Disc number 3, this bike, I can click on the bike and see what kinds of assets is on it, is on this product specifically. So I got 3 pictures, I got 2 documents, and now I can do an export for Swiss language. The purpose is original and the format is XML, or I can generate a PDF in those languages that I would have translated the product into. Swedish is not a translate, so in the middle I would click Swedish here, for instance, it would break down, but the other languages are here, so I can actually generate the PDF from this product. At the moment, it's only one product at a time and one PDF at a time, but we are actually continuously working on an expansion of this product to make it possible for you to take more than one product into a download and a PDF. My goal is actually that we have to be able to create a solution where you actually can download a product catalog specific for the customer. That's where we're looking at the moment. But if we were to download this, for instance, in JSON, clicking on download, I would get, oh, that's not the price I would like to see. That's page I'd like to see. What would actually have come up if, it's live. It would actually have a JSON code of the product so that you actually implement the coding in the other customers' websites. Jumping out of the demo, because actually the last success was not a success, so back to the spreadsheets. You can get started with this platform or with the PIM or with any further questions by reaching out for me. Again, as I said, this presentation will be sent to you in just a second in a PDF format. I'll be happy to assist you in any way I can. And of course, please reach out to me or my colleagues around the world, because we will be happy to help you. I wish you all a very nice day. If you have any questions, come in. In any case, I would be happy to make you welcome again another time. Thank you. Goodbye.